Alright, I figured it out. I figured it out, Agent Sushi. I know how we are going to make this exhibit totally look much better. Also, do be careful, I don't want you falling in there. Oh, you're such a good kitty. Which is good, because actually, I stayed out a little bit too late. And now look at it. I wish I had a bow and arrow. There's nasties hiding around here. We just had a bunch of zombies come by and try to give me trouble. But all they gave me was more zombie jerky for the dogs. Oh, what's going on with you, tree? Tree, what are you doing? That's not how trees grow. I bet an Enderman came by and helped himself to a block. They do that a lot around here. I don't really have much of a problem with it, though. Oh, yes. How you doing, dear? Dear the bear. I really, you know, I'm beginning to think having giant pits filled with bears just kind of lurking around the zoo is not the best way to go. Bob the Third's doing good. Lily, how you doing? A little hungry? Some zombie jerky for you, darling. Kate, you too? Come on. I miss having my dogs with me. So they're going to come and join us because I have figured out how I think we are going to handle the issue of the dirt box. Not looking quite as nice. Like, see, it's just like boring dirt walls. And actually, I think I'm going to change out those orange poppies. They're not working for me, Tate. Tate, Lily, sit. Oh, you guys, you stole more zombie jerky. Just because you're one low on your health doesn't mean you need to eat more. See, your tummies are going to get too full. Then you can't go swimming, Tate, and I know how that would just break your heart. Oh, I'm sorry, Agent Sushi. I don't think I have any fish on me. Oh, wait. There was a fish. Alright, let me go ahead and grab you a fish, my lovely kitty. There you go. Just because. Plus her name's Agent Sushi, it totally works. Alright, but hello everyone and welcome back. We are going to continue working on the cougar exhibit today, which is actually coming along so fast. Blueberry plant! I want the blueberry plant. Let's see, what else? Bright grass, ivy, some nice dark grass. Let's see, do I want the pitcher? Ooh, the cyan bellflower. Ooh, yes, I want some of those. The yellow columbine. Not the tall reed grass. Don't know about the dark vines. Anything else? The orange bellflower, probably. What about in here? I love having all these plants to choose from. Ooh, orange columbine. I love it. Some marigolds. Oh, they're just so beautiful. Look at all these plants. There's so many of them. I'm actually going... Ooh, the koru. The koru might look really good. Uh-oh. Okay, crisp plant, you can go back. But, bye bee. Look at the little bee. Every time I take the plants out, it seems like the bees start showing up. Wait, I actually need that. Let's put away some of the bones, the egg, the string, that flower. Actually, I need the bones to make more bone meal. Make sure nothing's going to blow me up. I really should probably be protecting this greenhouse. So we'll work on a cool greenhouse as a side quest pretty soon. Because we do need somewhere to put all of our amazing plants! By the way, the plant mod, the Timpack Timbits, that I love, he's one of my favorite mod authors, really nice guy too, is going to update soon! I can't wait! And he's going to put in some really cool plants. Agent Sushi, here, come on. There! I just don't want you falling in. This is a cougar exhibit. And as adorable a cat you are not a cougar. Alright, so let's see. Let's start by getting some of these orange poppies replaced. I just think they stand out a wee bit too much. And we're going to put those guys and some of these guys. Ooh, and maybe some of those guys. But this exhibit is really coming together so fast. I'm so excited. That is what happens when you finally have the resources you need to be building. And it's been so fun just staying on the zoo for once and working on making it look nice. Ooh, look at that. Oh, this koru is beautiful. I love it. Also, I've been thinking... Let's see. I think, yeah, there's stone down here. So, cougars. Today we are going to learn a little bit more about cougars, also known as the mountain lion, the puma, the catamount. There's quite a few names for cougars, which is probably related to the fact that they have one of the largest... Oh, that's so pretty. One of the largest ranges of a land mammal. Ooh, look at that. That's so pretty. In North America. They spread through the Americas. They go up towards Canada. They are present... gotta get up there somehow. Oh, I heard a demon horse. Oh, look at our little blocks. I have to finish working on some of those details. They are present in South America, but where their territory begins to overlap with some of the other apex predators, they tend to be smaller. Like the... Oh, that was an egg. Huh. Oh, it's a floating egg. Yes, we are the land of floating eggs. Thank you very much, chickens. All right, put that there. I think that'll look really good. Do I want... Maybe put one of the orange columbines. Let's put the yellow. No, let's put one of the orange columbines up here, too. Oh, hello, floating egg. Yes, very nice to see you. Let's see, where should we put it up here? Right about there, I think. There we go. That should be nice and pretty. But I was thinking we could kind of cover up the giant wall of dirt by building some custom trees right there. So let's just go ahead. And not too big, because we don't want our catamount to escape. But just enough to kind of give it some flair. There we go. We'll come over on this side. And break up just the monotony of staring at a giant dirt wall. That just can't be fun for our big cat. Which is also because these guys really like densely forested areas. That's one of their things. And they also appreciate a good rock ledge. So we might actually, I was thinking we can build a sunning rock ledge. Oh my gosh, egg. Please just get in my inventory. Stop floating around my face. I'm always worried that being magnetic, one of these eggs is going to just like swirl around and then smash into my face and I'll have yolk all over my face. Thank you very much for the donation, chicken. Oh, got some holes here. Probably more Enderman. Hello, bee. How's that looking? Kind of sad. Let's add a little bit more to that tree. Let's jump over here. We do want to make sure that our catamount cannot escape. Let's see, do that. That's better. That's better. And then come over here. Oops. Do a little bit of this. Boink. I probably need to put some fencing up top, too. Alright. Oh! There's that baby zombie noise again. I keep hearing... Oh! There! and it's named, no less! I totally forgot. I totally forgot about you. I'm sorry, Sam. Hi! You know, I'm just gonna put a little bit of a protective... There we go. Now I'm not gonna fall in. I really need to stop putting dangerous creatures into holes like this. But yes, that is the baby zombie that I captured. I totally forgot about him, and I even named him Sam because it was on my name list. It's for our baby zombie daycare. Oops, sorry about that, apple tree. And also, this is a chicken that I am assuming is related to Bob the Third. I'm thinking that Bob is sending out some spies or associates throughout the zoo. Whoops, didn't mean to do that either. I just want to pick some apples. I just love this. I love how the apple orchard is starting to look again. I remember when we lost all of our apples to that terrible apple orchard disease. That was so sad. Alright, Lily and Tate are sitting dutifully. Good doggies. Good doggies. How's that look? That looks much better. The tree could use a little bit of work still, but that looks much better. And it looks great having changed out those plants. I think I'm actually going to collect the columbine and just, let's see, maybe put a blue one over there. Or, nope, up there. Yeah, let's put a blue one up there. And then let's build another tree right there. And maybe one right there. And one down there. Because the dense tree area is what they enjoy. And we want to try to make sure that we give the best of the best to our zoo residents. Because that is what that's just how we roll here. Alright, and then we're going to come over here. Build a little tree. Want to make sure it's not the kind of tree where she can escape. You know, I've been thinking about something. I've been thinking, you know how in normal zoos you go and they are like, oh, this polar bear exhibit will be finished in 2020. And you're like, that's years away. Why on earth does it take so long to finish an exhibit? It should be pretty easy, right? Just provide the basics that the animal needs, put some enrichment toys in the area. And, well, I'm kind of eating my own words there because I'm learning it's kind of hard work. There's a lot of planning, actually, of just the layout and the plants. Let's see. I think we're just going to kind of pull that up and let that little tree just be like that. I think we might give it, actually, Doink. And we might actually get in there and come here, block. There we go, there's my axe. Yoink. And boink. There we go. Aw, that's much better. That looks really cute too. I actually really like that. I'm kind of tempted to change this out with dirt blocks now. Add more plants. Of course, I'm always tempted to add more plants. That's usually something I have to restrain myself from doing. Alright, let's take you out. We'll put you somewhere else because you're still really cute. And then I want to put... Was it right here? Yeah, it was right here. Let's put the white hawkhead. Is that what this is? White hawkweed will go right there. I'm going to start looking up facts about these different plants because I do think they're super duper cool. And, like, these salal berries are apparently really yummy to eat. Someone commented and said, oh, we've got those berries around here and they're delicious, which is really fun. I didn't know that about them. So I'm going to start looking up facts about the various plants that we use, too. Oops. Didn't mean to destroy that vine. There we go. Oh, good. There's plenty of vines over there I could use. And we'll just kind of fill in some of the gaps where we don't have any plants or anything with some vines. Not... Oh, no, not wood. Well, I guess we're building a tree there. And then, let's see, a little bit more. That egg is still chasing me. I swear I'm going to get, like, yolk on my face. I just know it. You know, put some vines like that. But our lovely cougar. Turns out, cougars are very solitary animals. They pretty much only hang out when it's time to make cougar babies. And cougar kittens are supposed to be really adorable. They have spots. They lose their spots as they get older. Cougar mama will have about 2 to 4 kittens. Pretty much any time of the year. Spring is a little more common for the baby having season, but a female cougar can actually have kittens any time of the year. So, you know, she's in the mood to try to raise her own litter. In summer, who's to stop her? Little tree, what am I going to do with you? I'm going to trim you a little bit, prune you back some. There we go. Alright, that's a little bit better. And then I kind of wanted to build a tree right here. Yeah, that's okay. We'll build it right here. Even though it kind of intersects a little bit, I still have to finish up putting some of the small plant blocks. Or the small small blocks, there we go, the teeny blocks in around here. Mm-hmm. There we go. Just kind of want this to stand out. Nice little tree. There we are. Fill the back in a little bit. Maybe take that out. There, and then we can put the little blueberry bush, and let's see what else. Maybe some koru, the columbine. The orange columbine probably. That would look cute down here. Blueberry bush right there, columbine right there. That does look good. Oh, I like that. All right, what else should we put down here? Let's see. Got a few more pieces. Got the orange bellflower, which I think. Can I, oh, I forgot I used little blocks on that. Let's see, can I fix that somehow? Like, maybe... Doo-doo-doo. Still little blocks. Where did I put that wand? I need to fix that. Let's see. Not in here. But yeah, you guys, actually, I think it would be really cool if people designed some bonsai trees, and then we could have a bonsai tree garden thanks to the little blocks mod. And that was the distant sound of a meteor falling somewhere. Ah, there it is. I knew you were hiding around here somewhere. Okay. Change back. Change back somehow. Become not little block anymore. I command you. I'm still learning how to use this thing. Meh. Meh, 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 meh. Okay, I don't think it's working. I'll just have to play with that later, so we'll just have to not put the beautiful orange bellflower there. We'll put it down here then. I'll show you. I'm gonna put the orange bellflower right there, put the yellow columbine right there, and let's go ahead and get some grass growing down here. Woo, look at that! We'll take that flower with us. Wow, look at this. I've actually never used bone meal to make grass before. Oh, it's so cool. I feel like it's a magic wand. Ta-da, plants. Ta-da, more plants. Oh, if only my mods that I have managed to like, I want more. Give me more bone meal. This is fun. Once the mods update, then they'll have regen properties, and I can just collect flowers by bone mealing areas. That would be amazing. Okay, there we go. Ooh, look at that. Oh my gosh, it's adding so much detail. I love it. Oh, this is fantastic. Good job, Skeleton Farm. Good job. Alright, now let's jump over here. I think this should be good. Alright, let's do this. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. More grass. More. Ha ha ha. Oh, hello again, Bee. Jeez, this exhibit just seems... Oh, wow, look at it. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, goodness. Look at how pretty it is. Good. There's bees flying around. There's grass everywhere for that thick underbrush that the cougars prefer. Let's build its little rock ledge and another tree right there. And I'm trying to think if there's any other details. Maybe. No, other than that, we just have to take care of building the cougars' actual, like, little den down there. A few more of the little blocks, probably to curve over and make a proper rock ledge. Lily, Tate, Agent Sushi, I think we're almost done and ready to put Myla in here. This is going so fast. It took us how many episodes to build that snake exhibit over there? And like three, maybe, to build this? This is fantastic. All right, so let's see. Oh, where's my stone? Don't I have any stone left? Uh-oh. Man, that stupid baby zombie is stealing my silk touch pick. And now I have to actually cook stone again and struggle to get stone. Not cool. Alright, let's jump down here. Yes, hello, bear. Dear the bear. So sorry. Oh, and also, you know what I think we should do sometime very soon is get Bob the Third an iron golem. I'm pretty sure that the inheritance he has from his father, Bob the Second, you know, the money left over from the life insurance policy. Oh, yeah, we'll take this, and then I'm gonna cook some of the stone that we've got here. Oh, I have iron here. Cooking it, there we go. Put that away, no iron in here. Have some stone in here. Okay, man. I've got so much stuff now, it's always kind of an exciting surprise to see what's what. Oh, hi, horsey! And there's apple blossom, or apples blooming over there. I'm actually spending time here instead of running around on adventure, so now all the apples are growing on the apple trees since I've been tending to them. I think it'd be really fun to get somebody to take care of the apples, actually. An apple orchard specialist who you can collect the apples for. Can we sleep yet? Lily, Tate, you guys are such good doggies. We'll take a break after we get Myla in her new exhibit, and we'll have a picnic, and we'll go fishing, Tate, and we'll play with flowers, Lily. I have a beautiful new hibiscus over in the Illumination Garden to show you. Ah, oh, so fun. Ah, oh, there we go. Nice and safe. Don't have to worry about things. Phew. Alright. I love these lanterns. They're so pretty. Alright, but yes, cougars. They can also jump 14 feet high. They like to lurk over here in trees, or especially like on ledges above where their prey is. And they'll be like, there's my food. Pounce and eat it. And they can jump about, let's see, what was it? 14 feet high and 40 feet in diameter, or diameter in length. And that's what really surprised me. Oh, hello, you guys. I'm preferring grass right now. Thank you very much. They're so cute. What are these? I want them. White anemones. I've never seen them before. I think you can make a flower crown out of that. I so want to run around and collect those now. Then we can make a cute little flower crown to have for our little picnic that we'll have. That's so exciting! Maybe we should picnic with Bob and his new iron golem protection dude that he's gonna have. Alright, so I wanna make the stone ledge right here. I want to make a pretty nice stone ledge that she can climb up to if she wants to. So let's put this here. Maybe that's not quite what I wanted though. Come here, you. There's that. Okay. Let's extend this out. Make a nice little basking ledge. There we go. So she can just come up here and be like, ah, warm sun. Which is over there, but it's coming. Warm sun, shade from the tree of illumination, and the hammock tree, and there's another egg. That chicken is a very prolific layer. I really should invite it to come and stay at my barn. Alright, let's go ahead and get another tree right here, I think. Oh, I heard the chicken. If I can catch that chicken, I just might actually invite it to come along and come live at my barn. Can always use more free-range eggs. I'm gonna have guests soon, eventually. Their passports were once again denied. We're having some trouble with that, so I need to work on that, but... Is that you, chicken? No, it's just your egg. Alright. That ledge actually looks pretty nice. I think actually adding that back in shouldn't hurt things too much. No. I'm not gonna mess with it anymore. Let's go ahead and collect some vines. Ooh, chi-doo-chi. Oh, and we're going to also have to, before we add Myla in, I almost forgot, work on making the underground viewing area. That'll probably come out right about here. And then you can just look out and see her more close up and, like, if she's in her little cave. Alright, let's see. Let's come over here. There's that. Thank you very much, Vines. Put you over here. Let's see. Alright, now where to put you guys? Those will be growing soon, so that'll work nicely. Maybe put a few vines kind of around here to make that look a little nicer. Just let those grow down. We might eventually change these out with flowering vines, but to be honest, I like the green ones a lot. Yeah, we'll just leave that and we'll see how it turns out. And then I think I heard an Enderman. Still in my blocks again, are you, sir? Whoop, there's that egg floating in my face. I knew it. And I think we're about done. Let's pop up. Check it out. Lily, Tate, I'm really enjoying this. Really enjoying this. It looks fantastic. Looks like she's going to enjoy it too, I think. Let's see. Good. Got enough plants in here. Good. I'm just going to kind of tidy up that spot. Okay, Lily, Tate, hang on a second. Do I have any wheat, you guys? I have 2 wheat. That's not enough. Nothing in there either. So many backpacks to sort through. Nothing in here either. Oh, except a couple crabs. I really need to take care of those crabs. Whoopsie daisy. Let's see. Double checking everything. Yeah, I think we just need to put in some stuff into her cave and then bring her on over. And I think it's okay to work on the underground viewing area after we have her in this exhibit, because I don't want to keep her in that little teensy makeshift thing any longer than we have to. Speaking of teensy makeshift things, look how many livestock animals we have inadvertently caught because they just walk off this little ledge and right in there. And we have one chicken that's like kind of holding on for her life. Trying not to fall in. I'd be very careful, chicken. I'd be so very careful, because Cublet looks like she's a little hungry. If you come up this way, you'll be fine. Poor chicken. They aren't always the brightest things in the world. But alright, I think we've got everything. So, I'm just going to go get some straw from the barn, and then we'll make sure that we make a little table with some mutton, because that's one of the things that cougars eat. Sheep, unfortunately, especially domestic sheep, because they're kind of easy prey. Cattle, and I mean, come on, you build a fence, and the mountain lion, which normally has to roam miles and miles every day of its territory to find food, walks up to this fence and is like, hey, there's food right there in a contained area. I'm going to go eat it. So that happens a lot, and it causes a lot of rifts between the mountain lions and conservationists and farmers. And then let's see. We definitely will probably put the fencing around the top just to make sure she can't escape. But other than that, I don't believe it. I don't believe it was that easy. This is fantastic. Lily Tate, having the resources at my fingertips and not having to travel off into who knows where just to get the basics so I can build a freaking exhibit is amazing. This is fantastic. All right, good. All right. I'm going to go grab that straw, and we'll finish up her little den, and then we'll be good to go. So I will see you guys in just a little bit. Bye-bye.